Why do passenger aircraft have double sets of wheels? Because if you lose one of them, the other will save your day. On the 24th of July 2024, an ATR 72-600 from Green Africa Airways departed from Ilorin Airport's runway 05 in Nigeria. Ground personnel observed an object was rolling off the aircraft. The runway and its vicinity were inspected, but nothing was found. 55 minutes later, the aircraft landed on Abuja Airport's runway 22.
30, 20, 10.
When the aircraft had parked at the apron, the ground personnel notified the crew and no seal was missing. Okay, folks, this is personal. I have flown this aircraft. Hello aviators, how are you today? My name is Magnar Nordahl. I'm an ATR captain and instructor. From 2021 to 2022, did I fly with Green Africa Airways in Nigeria. The company is based in Lagos and operates three ATR 72-600. They serve 9 destinations in Nigeria. Losing a wheel is really serious, because a wheel on the loose can have a lot of energy and can hurt people and property. It is less dramatic for those on board, because each landing gear member has at least 2 wheels, and the aircraft can land safely with 1 wheel missing. This is not the first time an aircraft has lost a wheel. It has happened to Airbus, Boeing, Dash 8, ATR, etc. Why does it happen? There can be many reasons, but first, let us have a look at this flight. Nigeria's NSIB released a preliminary report on the 28th of August 2024. The captain was the pilot monitoring, PM, and the first officer was pilot flying, PF. At 12:01:30, Green Africa Flight 45 Delta lined up for takeoff on runway 05. Green Africa Flight 45 Delta departed Ilorin to Abuja with an estimated arrival time of 44 minutes. Personnel of Green Africa's ground handling company reported to Green Africa's Ilorin station manager that an object was observed rolling off the aircraft during the takeoff. At 12:23, the operator relayed information about the object that rolled off the aircraft to Ilorin Tower. The runway and its immediate vicinity were inspected, but none was recovered. Apparently, this information was not relayed to the pilots. At 12:52:09, Abuja radar cleared Flight 45 Delta for approach to runway 22 and was advised of rain overhead the station. At 12:52:27, Flight 45 Delta established contact with the Abuja Tower and was cleared to land on runway 22 with surface wind from 110 degrees at 80 knots and a wet runway. That gives 6 knots tailwind component. This is well inside the limitations of 10 knots tailwind. The autopilot was disengaged at about 100 feet radio altimeter. The aircraft landed at 12:57:34, 1222 meters from the threshold of runway 22, past exit Alpha 3. That is beyond the touchdown zone, which is 900 meters long. Normally, you land near the 300 meter marker, like you see on this video.
50, 40, 30, 20, 10.
It is unusual to land that far in, as an ATR can easily use exit 4 after landing. Okay, they had some tailwind, but still. The crew noted the aircraft's tendency to veer left and extended the landing roll to slow the aircraft before exiting the runway at Alpha 6, 1780 meters from the touchdown point. Again, this is an unusual long distance. 1222 meters plus 1780 meters is 3002 meters. The crosswind from the left would also have affected directional control because the aircraft has a natural tendency to weather vane into the wind. The nose wheel assembly consisting of two wheels was installed on 17 of July 2024. After installation, the aircraft underwent 62 landing cycles. That is not much. A self-locking nut was observed to have shown signs of axial play upon replacing the nose wheel assembly after occurrence. The nut was from the same batch as that installed prior to the wheel detachment. The batch was quarantined. The locked nut consists of a bolt with a hole, which is secured with a castle nut and a split pin. This prevents the nut from unscrewing itself. So what can go wrong? Here are three possible scenarios. 1. A hard touchdown on the nose wheel may result in a metal fatigue that sooner or later will develop into a fracture. Scenario 2. A missing split pin. This should not happen, but this is easy to discover during a walkaround. If the pin is missing, the nut will unscrew itself. Scenario 3. Manufacturing imperfections. Aircraft grade hardware is made of high quality materials. However, unauthorized parts can be a problem in this industry. As the report suggests, they discovered damage to a nut from the same batch as the nut used on the missing wheel. So this might be the possible cause for this incident. So, what is the conclusion? Do not land on the nose wheel. Do a proper walk around and make sure you use approved parts. And that's all for this time. Thank you for watching. Have a wonderful day and happy learning.